I just wanted to say, to recap quickly, that what I've been talking about, and will continue talking about the rest of the week, the aspect of rhythm and the centrality of it in musical performance, and that so often it is lost, and you saw what it does to the performance when you put it in, and the whole question how to do it, that it's not a separate element, but to try to see how it is woven into tone production, into the shaping, and how it all works together and really forms the craft of music playing, of expressive playing. It always goes back to technique, and I just wanted to maybe, in 60 seconds, redefine it, at least for me, what I mean by technique, because we work so much with technique, the how to play. But I wanted to make it a little bit more inclusive, that the word technique, in my vocabulary at least, means knowing how to use the playing apparatus in the way it was intended to be used, in the way that prodigies and great virtuosi do it on an instinctive level. While it must include the ability to play fast and even scales, arpeggios, trills, double notes, chords, octaves, leaps, etc., it must also include the means with which to express music. And those are the added elements. I always say it's added elements. You don't change. You have to add things. And that means producing sounds of every kind, shaping phrases, making long lines sound long, treating rests correctly, as well as bringing out the particular pulse, lilt, or swing of a piece of music. And it's all part of the craft of music making. And this craft is part of the technique. It's still the know-how. How do we do it? You know, again, how to bridge intention and result. And I went through several pieces, and I thought to show you something in the first ballad that we know so well, and to show you another aspect of it, because we think so much of this music as lyrical music, and it is, but we somehow don't know that rhythm is a central issue in lyrical playing as well. I've shown it through the years in terms of tone production, shaping, enslavement to notation, meaning how to get legato lines when you can't connect. How do we do it? So I've shown at the beginning of it, how do you take the first note and make it longer? You know that if you just go down, it stops. But if you come down, and again, going back to the whole issue of tone production, which, you know, we've spent so much time on, what makes a rich sound sound rich? Which we, I think, for the most part, know by now, but how do we continue it? And then the shapes. I showed in terms of this shape, then this. As opposed to not shaping, which makes it, that shape, as we know, there's no expressivity without shape. I mean, the shaping and tone production are the two most basic elements in musical expression, but not the only ones, but the most basic. But I wanted to go to continue from there, because of course those lines also, when it sounds very rhapsodic and improvisatory, it still has a beat. And again, when we have rubato and we take the time, at the moment that we have the beat, it has to be emphasized or there is no rhythm. But when we go into the moderato from measure six, and into here. Now, again, the whole issue of weak beats, which I've tried to redefine as less strong, different from each other. Again, that each beat has a different role within the measure, which is possible to do through shaping. That if everything is played down, everything sounds the same, and through the motion of shaping, we able, the beats, it defines the placement of the beats as well, and then we can accentuate certain, bring out certain notes. Well, what Chopin does here is that, in other words, we would consider this, the first C, as being a weak note. It comes on the off beat, comes after the third beat, but clearly Chopin writes it as a half note, puts an accent there. And he puts each note, he makes it half note, then a dotted quarter, then a quarter, then an eighth. So he wants you to linger on those notes, bring them out. If you want to look at it just as something that you connect, physically connect, you're going to get into stretching. It's not possible to really hang on to it. And when you hang on to them, you're stretched. You can't shape. You can't get the arm over the different notes so that you can get the sound through the weight and speed into the key. And the pedal is down anyway. So he's from the beginning showing you what is normally called as a weak beat. He's strengthening it. And that's why I say that the way you treat, the way we are told to treat very often, the so-called weak beats weakens the piece, because the composer very often goes to those notes and make them strong. So if we have the basic beats and we treat them correctly, we can then accentuate or emphasize more or swing more on the notes that come off the beat. And that's what he does. Physically, if we do it as a down, it sounds like there is a down and there is another down. But the understanding of shaping shows the continuation, so that you can pa. See, in other words, how do we do it? How do we play that and not make it sound like a downbeat? It's a continuation. This is a down and a down. This, you see, goes a little bit forward and immediately expresses it as an offbeat. And then you have another more major beat here and more here. But all together, now, I've shown this very often to show how we cannot connect those legato lines that they're supposed to sound connected, but physically what they show is the substitution right there, which twists and turns, and you're not going to get a legato line anyway, but you can connect it through the inner voice with tone and with shaping. Tone and shaping is so powerful that you can go from here to there and to another note, but if you continue to the other hand, but if you continue the line through the shaping and through matching sounds, the continuation of sound, you will still get a line that sounds legato, whether it's connected or not. So we have this also. This is your downbeat, so it goes here. It's not, which often it's played, and then people usually play it like that. But it's a misplacement of the beats, because the downbeat, which is the strongest one, comes, boom, he resolves to here.